Hello everybody, welcome back to Doc Shala. So today our topic of discussion will be relining and rebasing of a denture. So let us now look at a question from Dental Dex. So the question is, a reline is indicated on any denture when the diagnostic information indicates that a reline will effectively solve the patient's chief complaint. So when the denture base adaptation is the major defect in the prosthesis. So here in the question he has given two statements. Okay, so the main thing we need to understand is that whether the two statements are true or false, or is one statement true or the other statement true. So we need to just analyze the statements and tick the correct answer. Okay, so this is the first statement that he has given. The second statement is that a reline is contraindicated when there is excessive overclosure of the vertical dimension. So a large decrease in vertical dimension, when there is a large decrease in vertical dimension. In this case, new dentures are indicated at proper vertical dimension. So you need to just understand the statements first. So in the first statement, he's giving an indication of relining a denture. So he gives an indication that whenever the patient comes, patient already wearing the dentures comes with the chief complaint that the denture is not properly fitted. So then it is indicated for reline. So that is what is the meaning of first statement. And the second statement is about the contraindication. So a contraindication is that when there is a large decrease in vertical dimension, when there is large decrease in vertical dimension, so it is indicated that new dentures have prepared a proper vertical dimension rather than relining the existing dentures. So these are the two statements. So now let us see the concept of relining and rebasing, its indications and contraindications, so that we can arrive to the answer of this question. So denture relining. So what is denture relining? Relining is resurfacing the tissue side of a denture with a new material to fill the space that exists between original denture and the altered tissue contour. So we know that the residual alveolar ridge constantly undergoes resorption, so hence this will lead to change in shape, form and size of the ridge. So because of this rapid changing in the shape, form, size of the ridge, there will be indications and necessity for relining of the dentures so that it sits properly into the alveolar ridge. So it is done by two methods. It is direct method and indirect method. So recontouring of healing ridge progresses rapidly for 4 to 6 months. So I've said that the residual ridge resorbs rapidly. I mean, changes rapidly in shape, form and size. So when it changes, the healing ridge progresses rapidly, like recontouring progresses rapidly for 4 to 6 months and does not become stable until it is 12 to 12 months post extraction. So up till 1 year post extraction, the residual alveolar ridge continues to recontour and resorb so that it reaches a stable form. Okay, so during this condition, whenever we are preparing immediate dentures, they become ill-fitted within a short span of time. So because of this, they must be relined 5 months and at 10 months after delivery in order to compensate for the contour changes we are seeing in the ridge. Okay, then coming to denture rebasing. So denture rebasing is nothing but it is a procedure where the entire denture base is replaced with new material on existing prosthesis. Okay, here in the relining, so in relining what we do, we only replace areas which are required. Okay, which are required. Okay, whereas in rebasing, the entire denture base is replaced. Okay, so it is indicated when the denture base is porous or when the incomplete denture base is seen. just look at this image. So from this image you can appreciate that here only these parts are relined. Okay, these parts are added with new denture material. So this is a case where relining is done. Okay, here you can see that only the acrylic teeth are left. Okay, the entire denture base is being filled with new denture material. So this is called as rebasing. So I think now you have understood what exactly is relining and what exactly is rebasing based on this image. And you can just simply bookmark this image so that it will be easy for you to understand what is relining and what is rebasing, and you can easily arrive at answers when any kind of question is given. Okay, then coming to general considerations. So general considerations where we consider relining and rebasing a denture are: so when occlusal vertical dimensions should be satisfactory, so to perform relining and rebasing we need to make sure that the following conditions are compulsorily followed. Okay, so occlusal vertical dimensions should be satisfactory. Number two is that centric occlusion should coincide with the centric relation. So oral tissues should be in proper health. So if the oral tissues are not in proper health, we cannot do relining or rebasing. We should go for new dentures only. Okay, then denture base extensions are adequate and ensure distribution of masticatory forces over large area as possible. Okay, when the denture base extensions are adequate, that means that only a minimal shrinkage is allowed for relining. Okay, if the denture base is shrink the too lot, then relining or rebasing will never solve the problem. Okay, then correct interocclusal distance is maintained. Satisfactory speech with existing teeth arrangement. It is only indicated when the patient is able to speak properly with the existing dentures and the basic syllables are pronounced properly. If it is not, then don't go for relining. Okay, there, when there is no severe undercut or soft tissue defects. Okay, so what are the indications? So this is the main important slide which will help you in deriving the answer for your question. So let us see the indications. Indications is when the immediate dentures are 3 to 6 months after fabrication. So we have seen in the previous slide also that when we are preparing immediate dentures, we need to reline it or rebase it at 5 months and 10 months post placing the denture. Okay, then when residual alveolar ridge has resorbed and adaptation to denture ridge is poor. Okay, when the resorption is completed, so and when the adaptation of denture ridge is poor, then it is indicated for relining and rebasing. Okay, then when patient cannot afford new dentures, of course, but not when the general considerations are not met. Okay, simply that patient is not able to afford, you can't just do relining and rebasing. Okay, you should first consider the general considerations that we need to keep in mind. When all the general considerations are meted by the patient, then only you need to reline and rebase. It is not just like when a poor patient is coming to you, when he's saying that he's not having money and all, and when there is a problem with the ridges or when there is a problem with the vertical dimension, you can't go with relining. You need to prepare new dentures no matter what. So in that case, you need to educate your patient. Then when construction of new dentures along with prolonged steps can cause physical and mental stress for geriatric and chronically ill patients. Okay, then coming to contraindications. The contraindications are when excessive amount of resorption is seen. Okay, when excessive amount of resorption is seen, there will be changes in vertical dimension. Right, when there is presence of abused soft tissues, when the patient is having a TMJ disorder, when dentures with poor aesthetics and unsatisfactory jaw relations. Okay, unsatisfactory jaw relations are seen, then you cannot go for relining on rebasing. You should prepare a new denture. Then dentures causing speech problems. So as I've said before, the contraindications are quite opposite to that of the indications. Okay. When severe osseous undercuts are there, until surgical removal and healing. So until those osseous undercuts are surgically removed and they are healed properly, then only you can prepare. Well, you can try for relining, but mostly it is not indicated. It will be better if you just go with the new dentures. So an important note here is that when a patient wears a complete maxillary denture against a 6 mandibular anterior teeth, so okay, when he is having only 6 mandibular anterior teeth, it is very common to have to reline every so often due to loss of bone structure. So since we have a normal teeth against a ridge, right, against an alveolar ridge, the ridge gets resorbed so rapidly because of the effort and effect and stress from the normal teeth. Okay, so hence we need to do relining every often. So so if at all this relining is not performed, we can see a flabby maxillary anterior ridge being formed. So coming back to our question, so now with that we have seen the indications and contraindications, so you can just look at the statements once again. The statement one says that a reline is indicated on any denture when the diagnostic information indicates that a reline will effectively solve the patient's chief complaint, which is that the denture base adaptation is the major defect. So yes, when the denture base adaptation is the major defect and all the other general considerations are meted by the patient, then a reline is indicated, right? And a reline is contraindicated when there is excessive overclosure of vertical dimension. Of course, when the vertical dimension is changing, no relining and rebasing is done. Only prepare new dentures. Okay, so from this we arrive to the option that both statements are true. So this will be the right answer, right? So you need to just memorize the indications and contraindications and the general considerations we do when relining and rebasing a denture, so that you can arrive to the answer properly. Okay, I hope you have understood the concept properly. If you have liked our video, just subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos. You can also follow us on our Instagram at DocShala for dental content and at DocShala Medical for medical content. And you can also follow us on Telegram. Thank you and see you again in the next session.